Good morning. Today is Wednesday, April 15th, and we are in Oswald Chambers as normal. And today's title is called The Failure to Pay Close Attention. This is 2 Chronicles 15:17. The high places were not removed from Israel. Nevertheless, the heart of Asa was loyal to God all of his days. Asa was not completely obedient in the outward, visible areas of his life. He was obedient in what he considered the most important areas, but he was not entirely right. And what Asa had done was he had torn down all the idols and all the different wrong places of worship. He even came at his mom and removed her as queen and took down her idol. And it says in 2 Chronicles that he stomped it into the ground and burnt it. But nevertheless, he missed some of the smaller things in his life. The fact that it doesn't matter much to you may mean that it matters a great deal to God, the small stuff. Nothing should be considered trivial by a child of God. How much longer are we going to prevent God from teaching us even one thing? But he keeps trying to teach us, and he never loses patience. We say, "I know I am right with God," yet the high places, the small things, still remain in our lives. There is still an area of disobedience. Do you protest that your heart is right with God, and yet there is something in your life he causes you to doubt? His conviction causes us to reflect on that and wonder at it. Whenever God causes a doubt about something, stop immediately, no matter what it may be, stop doing it. Nothing in our lives is a mere insignificant detail to God. When he says stop doing it, I think we need to understand that it might be something that we see as very well intended. Even the well-intended small things, unless God has asked us to do them, and he checks our spirit to stop doing them, we need to stop. Are there some things regarding your physical and intellectual life to which you have been paying no attention at all? And I made a note here on the devotion that during this time of lockdown, many of us may be overeating and our physical needs attention. Maybe we are gorging ourselves on Netflix or some television program, and we need to stop and read the Word of God, or perhaps even bring our kids around and read the Word of God. So he challenges us here. He says, are there some things regarding your physical or intellectual life to which you have been paying no attention at all? If so, you may think you are all correct in the important areas, but you are careless, you are failing to concentrate or to focus properly on these other areas. You no more need a day off from spiritual concentration, which is what he's talking about in the small areas. He says, you no more need a day off from spiritual concentration on matters in your life than your heart needs a day off from beating. As you cannot take a day off morally and remain moral, neither can you take a day off spiritually and remain spiritual. God wants you to be entirely his, and it requires paying close attention to keep yourself fit. It also takes a tremendous amount of time. Yet some of us expect to rise above all our problems, going from one mountaintop experience to another, with only a few minutes of effort. One of the things I wrote down here in regards to living our life for God, if we begin to really make it a life lived for God, it becomes very normal. It becomes a lot easier. It's when we segment our lives, saying that this is this portion of life, and over here is my church life, and over here is this life. If we understand that all life belongs to God, and it's a life lived for God, it becomes a lot more easier. So let's pay attention to the small things in our life, the high places, as Asa was dealing with. Asa was right with God. He said for the rest of his days, he was right with God. But there were high places that he missed. And we don't know how those remaining high places affected the people around him. So let's watch for the high places, the small things. Let's pray. Thank you, Lord, for this insight that you care about us enough to to take us and help us see the high places or the things that need to come down. And I pray, Lord, that we would pay attention to the physical and the intellectual and the spiritual things that you would lead us to. Let us not see them as trivial. If they concern you, they concern us. Thank you, Lord. We pray this in Christ's name. Amen. See you tomorrow.